What you're about to watch is random, disjointed, and poorly edited. Viewers may experience piston seizure, driveline malfunction, or low compression.
Monster kinetic energy drink.
Lay people, and even some street riders, view dirt bikes as inherently dangerous. The common assumption is that we're monster energy guzzling maniacs, worshipping at the altar of the metal militia with our ears tucked into our hats. Surely, all of us dirt bikers spend our weekends working on our Superman seat grabs and building dirt kickers to leap over Highway 101. The reality for most adult enduro riders is vastly different. Like many, I experienced anxiety and chest pain whenever my wheels leave the ground. The most extreme we tend to get is arguing about whether to stop at the pub or at Tim Hortons for end-of-the-day refreshments. Of course, single-track off-road riding does come with some risk. I think it was about 10 years ago, there was a report, and it placed enduro riders in a similar risk category as downhill skiers. That's a risk most of us would accept. Though enduro riding typically involves slower speeds than skiing, the frequent get-offs we experience can lead to injuries such as broken wrists, collarbones, and ribs. Most seasoned off-road riders have a list of injuries longer than an authentic recipe for tamales. As enduro riders age, we often transition to dual sport and eventually into adventure riding. This kind of riding has less technical terrain, more cruising, and therefore less physical exertion. There's also a reduced risk of minor injury from the typical trail ride get-offs. But dual sport riding typically happens at higher speeds than enduro, and adventure riding is even faster. This increased speed brings a much higher risk of severe injury or death. What we're really talking about here is kinetic energy, the energy an object possesses due to its motion. As I'm sure you'll all remember from elementary school, what looks like an auto-generated website password shows that kinetic energy, and consequently, the force experienced in a crash, increases with both mass and velocity. More fasty means more ouchy. If we mock up three impact situations, enduro, dual sport, and adventure, we can see how this force increases. To conduct these experiments, we had our interns build a stout wall and then ride each type of motorcycle into that wall at speeds listed below. If you would like to apply to be an intern at the Traction eRag, please apply here. We are now officially out of interns. The enduro rider first fractured his collarbone, but we immediately put him on the adventure bike for the third test. For context, keep in mind that it takes approximately 1,600 joules of impact force to break a human rib and 3,400 joules to break a tibia fibia. Here's the first. It's an enduro rider. Let's say that the motorcycle weighs 250 pounds. All you two-strokers are aghast. Rider weight, let's be optimistic, 185 pounds, slim and trim adult. Total weight is 435 pounds. The speed, let's say they're going 20 kilometers an hour, and for all you imperial countries, which I believe is only two in the world, that's 12.4 miles per hour. Velocity, 5.56 meters per second, and the approximate kinetic energy is 3,044 joules. Dual sport riding, let's look at that. The motorcycle weight, 350 pounds. I don't know what people are going to think about that weight. Rider weight, we're going to keep them at 185, slim and trim. I've had lots of comments when talking with this with other people about the idea that there's no way that a dual sport rider weighs 185 pounds. That makes the total weight at 535. Let's say they're going 60 kilometers an hour, which is 37.3 miles per hour. For all you Neanderthals. Velocity, 16.67 meters per second. Approximate kinetic energy, 33,679 joules. What a ridiculous jump up in the amount of impact force. Adventure bikes. The motorcycle weighs 550 pounds. That's 249 kilograms for all you metric weirdos. The rider weight, a slim trim and fit, 185. Nobody will agree that an adventure rider weighs 185 pounds. I'm an optimist. Total weight, 735 pounds of mass. That's 333 metric kilograms. Speed of 85 kilometers an hour, which is 52.8 miles per hour. So they're scooting along pretty good. The approximate kinetic energy of impact is 92,975 joules. That will kill you. Even without all of those made-up numbers, it's easy to understand why enduro riders are at a much lower risk compared to dual sport or adventure riders. The primary factor influencing the severity of crash outcomes is speed. Higher speeds result in significantly greater impact forces and potential injury. So where do we go from here? We're all getting older. You're now 2 to 3 minutes older than when you started the video. The exertion of pure off-road riding is getting more difficult, and minor injuries take longer to recover from. So what do you think? What's the risk-reward ratio that you're comfortable with? Do you trade less risk of minor injury for more risk of major injury? After a life of off-road exploits, are long cruisy ADV rides too dull? Thank you so much for sifting through this drivel. Hopefully you learned something. Many of you may have already known that. If you would like to get more of these videos, please click subscribe. Leave us a juicy comment. There's nothing we like more than reading controversial comments. There's no topic that's taboo, except religion, politics, gender, race, sex,